Hello everyone. Moving on to our next session, we have Mr. Vinayak Godse, VP of DSCI. He will give us insights on multiplying the efforts in cybersecurity. Please give him a big round of digital claps. Over to you, Vinayak.
Thank you, Sanam, and I would like to briefly run across through what we are doing in terms of cybersecurity R&D and how can we really multiplying the effort and what kind of contribution that National Center of Excellence for Cybersecurity and Product Entrepreneurship is doing. So I have some slides that I'll be presenting here. Through that slide, I will like to discuss with you about the effort that we can put together, we all can put together for multiplying the effort for cybersecurity R&D. What we really know is the typical R&D process. If we just look at the academic process or any R&D institutions process, we see that typically the use cases, requirements of new ideas has been thought about. And when you think about those ideas, basically you usually look at the research projects and proposals that do come from the academic institutions or R&D institutions, basically. And then we also, sometimes the most of these academic institutions or R&D institutions have their own technology lab, and they have the students from MTech and PhD students, basically, they help conducting those research, basically. These are typically any R&D institutions or academy institutions, they would really run through this kind of a process in terms of doing the research, and that research then they need kind of a funding R&D budget by some institutions like MIT or some government institutions like DST, and you have funding support given, and project review committee has been set up, and this project review committee, basically, they do provide a kind of a guidance about how this research is happening, overall working. And then once the research, the typical outcome of this research is usually go as a publication of paper or development of technology prototype or filing the IPR or even publishing the code on GitHub, basically. Or even sometimes the research may entail largely to deployment of product as well. So this is a typical R&D process that do happen in a typical any project that this particular captures how things are happening. But if you really want to multiply this effort, basically, I try to put together some of the ideas of what DSCI or National COE here, then probably we need to have a good effort in terms of looking at the research agenda and priorities. So we need to define them very well in terms of understanding how the things are going. We need to attract the attention of these engineering students in cybersecurity space that we need to be looking at. We need to nurture programming and mathematical skills, basically because cybersecurity is a deep technology product, and at the same time, it also requires a lot of mathematical skills as well. We probably need to provide data sets for real-life scenarios for researchers, basically, and that's some of the challenge that we see. And also, what is happening currently in the research side, we need to have good visibility about the research work and capability. Apart from that, we also need to look at, because that's what we have been hearing since morning, is how do we productize this research, basically? How can we bring the research to deployable level of prototype, basically? How can we bring this particular research as an enterprise in the context of current enterprise security market? How can we bring the research which is fitting into the existing technology stack of organization, basically. And most of the time what happens, if you deploy something, it gives you a lot of intelligence and learnings as well. So how can we bring this kind of effort and capability that we build to the level, it deploys and it brings a lot of this intelligence and learnings to you, basically. Then another important aspect that needs to be thought, right, is how can we get industry involved in the research process, actually. That's a very important aspect, and we are trying to do that from the Data Security Council of India and National COE, especially from the National COE. कि इन्वॉल्विंग इंडस्ट्री इन अ रिसर्च वर्क, हाउ कैन वी एंगेज द रिसर्च कम्युनिटी इन मोर इन टर्म प्रोडक्ट पायलटिंग एंड प्रोटोटाइप काइंड ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज बेसिकली सो दैट वी वर्क विद इंडस्ट्री. How can we make it sure that the research lead to some kind of startup process, or we can have research incentivization for somebody to translate that research into some kind of product? And if not, then can we have a progressive technology transform kind of norms where any existing technology product company can leverage from this research basically? Apart from that, basically, we also need to look at, because India is a recommended destination for the R&D, global R&D basically, we need to look at how can we bring this global R&D, how can we engage with Indian players basically, which are working in a global market, how can we leverage them to reach, increase the reach of our R&D program, how can we bring the private sectors R&D effort into the foray, how can we bring this collaboration between academia, industry, startup and government together to scale up this effort of cybersecurity R&D. So these are just framework that I try to present in terms of what we need to do in terms of multiplying the cybersecurity R&D in the country. And we are charting our effort in these directions that I have just put together in this particular slide. So let me take you through the National Cyber Center of Excellence for Cybersecurity Technology Development Product Entrepreneurship. This is a joint initiative of our Ministry of Electronics and IT and DSEI, primarily meant for six key objectives to be met. One is the creating an ecosystem for cybersecurity technology development and entrepreneurship, translating the work in terms of the R&D work into the product. So this is what we will be closely and have been closely working with academic industry to see what kind of R&D that is going on and how can we translate that R&D into product. How can we enhance the technology stack of the existing companies? Another important priority area for us. That's something we have been looking at. One of the important area is also creating investment ecosystem for security technology, technology and entrepreneurship. Creating the market adoption or ensuring market adoption of development developed technology is another important part. And the India as a destination for R&D and product development is another important part basically you want to look at. So when we look at these six objectives basically that National CEO is achieving and trying to achieve basically and trying to satisfy this mandate, it is primarily doing through the three different key pillars basically. One is the technology development as one of the important player. Other is the technology incubation, and third is the creating market basically for the technology R&D actually. So when we are doing that basically, and when we are looking at these key three pillar like a technology incubation and market development, we are looking at how exactly we have been creating the technology as a focus, then how can we engage with the entire research and academic community in the country basically. So, and this is a academic network of a National Center of Excellence for Cybersecurity Technology Development and Entrepreneurship, IIT Kanpur, IIT Kharagpur, IIT Mumbai. We have been working with all of these IITs. We have been working with the IIIT Delhi, IIIT CCT, IIIT Kalyani, MNIT Jaipur, COEP Pune. So this mixed up the public plus private universities plus some of the very specialized universities like RC Bose Center of Cryptology or CRL Center, Institute of Advanced Mathematics basically. So we are looking one hand for the technology development side, from the research side, we are cleanly working with academic institutions, and we are creating this network and we have been expanding this network basically of academic institutions. And see the work which is happening in R&D perspective and seeing the possibility of translating that work into the kind of product and also fostering the R&D or promoting this R&D in the country basically through academic institution. And then I'm just trying to conclude this discussion with one key effort that we are trying to put, and I'm just trying to list out. So one of the important things that we have been trying to do as a part of the National CEO is we have a technology lab set up which has the security solutions. We have also set up a experimental SOC. We had been setting up a hardware IoT security lab at National COE, and we are setting in a such a way that we work with entire ecosystem that we have with us. The SCADA security lab is also coming in. The products testing lab we are setting up. We are also setting up a digital forensic kind of a lab ecosystem. We are also creating the simulation lab. And we also have got up with the help of the NVIDIA and with the help of the SCADA. We also have the supercomputing facility with us, and now we are working on creating some kind of a lab setup of IoT security as well. So this is a technology lab, and we are seeing with academic network that we have, with the industry network we have, so how can we leverage this technology lab and also leverage the other labs which are academic institutions for the overall cybersecurity research and development. Apart from this, basically, we are undertaking various different initiatives as well. So we know that with IoT age coming in, the cryptography in a very limited resources, devices like IoT devices, cryptography implementation will be challenging, and that's where Lightweight Crypto Challenge we have set up with an aim like developing algorithms in this country which can work with the IoT ecosystem basically. Second part is the we have also initiated the crypto innovation series and trying to see academic and as well as startups work in cryptography and try to give really good kind of a support for the cryptographic innovation in this country. We are also now taking 5G security research on our agenda. So we are working towards one is to compiling those ideas and trying to make a plan to support those ideas actually. We also have some funds, and we are trying to create budget for funding or incentivizing the research in academic world basically. So currently we are running on almost 10 projects in the area of hardware security, IoT security and cryptography, and we have been closely looking at how can we bring industry together for the research incentivization that we have done for academic institution basically. We are also working towards looking at the new areas, emerging areas, trying to see what is happening globally here and trying to create a visibility about the effort which is going on in those areas basically across the globe actually, and how can we learn from that to focus our attention to the cybersecurity new areas for the research perspective. So this is some of the effort that we have been putting together from Data Security Council of India's National COE. We are also taking some of the key new initiatives as well. So one important initiative that we have been now taking is to compiling the use cases which can be solved from the AIML perspective. So we will be shortly publishing a report which would probably have almost 50 plus use cases, very intense use cases of cybersecurity which can be solved by the technology stack like AIML. And we also understand key for those use cases, somebody needs to be helping us with the data set. So we are now initiating a kind of a campaign in the DS from the National COE is to create a compile these data sets which can be provided to researchers basically. So there's some of the effort that we are putting together, but we know that this needs to be scaled up. This needs to be, we need to have create momentum at a different level, at a private sector level, at a startup level, at an academy level. And we are here to support all of those initiatives. And we also can channelize many of the government kind of efforts or initiatives to these R&D initiatives of our individual organization or academic institutions or R&D institutions as well. So with this, I would like to conclude my presentation briefly about what COE does and what we have been doing to multiply the effort in cybersecurity R&D in the country.
Thank you so much, Vinayak. Vinayak, we have a question from the audience.
Yeah.
So Mr. Manish from TDB has asked, what about the mentorship ecosystem at National COE for market development and pitching for fundraising, also on IP creation?
Yeah, so this is an important area where we see the mentorship ecosystem. We are looking at from various different perspectives. So one is definitely from product and tech and technology perspectives. We are trying to look at one is the researcher side, and other is basically the technology experts all across the country and different domains basically. So technology side mentorship is one important part. The investment ecosystem, so we have been working with a lot of investors in this country. Recently, there is a Bloom Venture Capital published a report about the cyber thesis which is a very concentrated effort from some of those kind of investors to invest into cybersecurity. So now there are many investors which have been now looking cybersecurity as a promising area. So some time back we also hosted a cybersecurity investor conference for cybersecurity innovation basically, and that brought a lot of investors together, and that is also creating quite a good momentum for the investment community. So we have people from the investor community to help the startup and even help the academic institutions as well, and we will be talking to some of them in the afternoon. Another important part of the organization building is also very important part. So creating startup ecosystem and building organization ecosystem is very important part. So we are getting people and institutions working with us to build the organization. We are also looking at the market development. So we take these, because we have the membership base all across the different integral, we take these startups and even R&D work basically to the industry actually. And we have the CISO community, which is a buyer of security, also as a our one of the mentor kind of a ecosystem. And we are also looking at some of the policy specific people, because some of the startups working in security and privacy, they would be they have to comply with the policy ecosystem, and at the same time they would be creating some of the new policy issues as well. So this kind of different segment that we look at when we try to create a mentorship ecosystem for the both academia R&D as well as the startup ecosystem.
Thank you, Vinayak, for the great insights into cybersecurity R&D. We will now proceed with individual sessions from our exhibitors, BARC, CDAC, CSIR, who will be showcasing their research work. We also have an exhibition all open for everyone. So please stay connected. We will be starting the next session in the next few minutes. Thank you.
Yeah, let me actually request all these participants here, please do visit the exhibition area and try to interact with all those kind of researchers here coming from the all academic institutions as well as the R&D institutions. And we'll get to surprise to see the kind of work which is happening in the country in cybersecurity R&D.
Sure. Thank you so much.